church. This morning we're going to be singing a couple of pretty good songs. First one is Savior, Like a Shepherd, Lead Us, hymn number 381 in your red hymnal. Singing 3095, Somebody's Knocking at Your Door. If you want to tap your feet or snap your fingers, go right on ahead.
Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door. Jesus calls you, somebody knocking at your door. Jesus calls you, somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door. Can't you trust him? Somebody's knocking at your door. Can't you trust him? Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door.
Good morning. Thank you so much for allowing the youth to lead you today in worship. This means a lot to them, and it's always great for Jeanette and Linda and I to get to see them be the leaders and kind of take over for a few minutes. We do have a few quick announcements. I know on the screen it told you that we're going to have a Valentine-based murder mystery that was originally scheduled for Saturday the 11th. That date has been changed. It's now going to be Sunday the 12th. So that's the very next day. We'll be doing an early dinner, late lunch at 2:00. So I hope you'll still join us. And then we also want to remind you that today is our last day for taking Super Bowl sub orders, and we'll be delivering those to you next Sunday during worship time. So, guys, did I get all the announcements? All right, that's it.
Please join us in our call to worship. Give the King your justice, O God. And righteous. May he judge your people with righteousness. Let the mountains bear prosperity for the people and the hills in the righteousness. May he live while the sun endures, and as long as the moon throughout all generations. In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound till the moon be no more. Please greet each other.
This morning's reading is from Deuteronomy 15, verse 10. Give generously to him, and do so without a grudging heart. Then because of this, the Lord of your God will bless you in all your work and everything you put your hand to. Now, if you center yourself in a silent prayer, please. Oh God, giver of gifts, thank you so much for everything that you give us in our life and for all those wonderful volunteers around the world helping in any way they can. Give them protection from any sort of outside force and let us give to them graciously as you have always given us gracious life, and as your Son taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Second reading is from Deuteronomy 16:17. Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessing of the Lord your God, which he has given you.
I just wanted to make a couple of announcements, although I'm really loving sitting in the pew, by the way. Although I forgot to bring my Nintendo. Dang. This morning, we want to make sure and keep in prayer several things. This week, some of you may have heard that we lost three longtime members, Vera Matthews, Carl Erickson, and Fern Blewett. You'll hear a little bit later about different services and that kind of thing, but let's just keep the families in our prayers this week. Also keep in prayer all of those who are working for peace in our world. So thanks again to the youth, and back to them.
Okay, now for sermon in a nutshell. Nancy normally introduces it some way, but I don't know how she does it. You normally introduce it some way, but I don't know how you do it. Okay. All right. Have you ever traveled outside of the state where you live? I know I have. I've been to Japan, and that was...
I've been to Mexico. I've been to Canada.
What's the furthest place you have traveled? Like I said, I've went to Japan. That was the furthest place I traveled. What did you find different about the place that you traveled? What was the same? I guess what I found different was, like, the culture was different from here, the food, some of the stuff that they do. And what was the same? You know, I guess the kids are the same, like, you know, like they play video games and trading card games and stuff. And when we journey to other places, we learn that many people live differently than we do. In other countries, they may even have different languages, food, and customs. It may be a challenge to learn and appreciate these differences and have a compassion for people who live differently than us. Today, we are going to learn about the mission work that began in two churches, one in Winter Park, Florida, and another in Novicia, Kenya, that partnered together to create hope and help build a future for orphaned youth and children who are very poor. The initial partnership has grown to more churches in both the United States and Kenya in the past 6 years. Novicia, Kenya is about 8,000 miles away from us. To get an idea about how far it can take up to a whole day to travel there by airplane from the United States. You have to cross over the Atlantic Ocean. In Kenya, some of the things that you would find the same and some things you that would be different from here. For example, most of the people speak English, but they also speak Swahili and other languages of the tribe that they are in. Lots of kids like to play soccer. Many don't go to school after elementary school. The animals are different. Zebras, elephants, and giraffes live there. Join us in singing hymn number 408, The Gift of Love. This reading comes from Corinthians 2, verses 9 and 10. Now he who supplied the seed to the shower, sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your need for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness.
Let's look at a couple videos about PNUA's partnership and hope.
I'm George Munene. I'm an orphan. I have two brothers and one sister. I live together with them. My dad died in 1996, and my mom followed. The life became so hard, and we were left alone. I was working. I was just being paid 100 shillings per day. I had to use the whole 100 shillings for transport. Group started supporting us, and I was given just 3,500, and I bought seeds for potatoes, whereby I planted half an acre of potatoes. Potatoes did so good. The potatoes for 7,000 shillings. And I was given just 3,500.
When we supported George Munene and we started with food security, we supported him with onions. He decided to do agro business.
I had just half an acre, but now I've come up having 1 acre. I have maize here, and I've let in another piece of land there. Onions can give me more money than potatoes.
He has some that he has already sold at around 16,000 Kenya shillings, and they are still in the farm.
I can now employ 4 to 10 workers per day. I can now work for more pieces of land, have enough food for eating, and paying school fees to my brother.
George Munene can comfortably, actually we don't even support him to pay school fees for his children that are in school. He is doing that from the farming that he is doing, and we are really proud of
him. I want to be a millionaire once. I'd like to help the needy, help the orphans, because I don't want to see them passing what I passed. Working with Kinamba to Mine Group is a very good thing I've ever come across. Because when we are together with a group, they do make my day. I'm George Munene. I do farming as my business. Asante sana.
My name is Ruth Gathuku. I'm 20 years old.
Life has not been very easy since the day my daddy died in 92. I was jobless, and sometimes it was rare to find something to put on the table.
I'm Alex Soka. I was neglected by my parents. I was driven away by the man that I got was my father. So I used to migrate from one house to another looking for help.
My name is Ameri Nyarobi. We were born 4 in our family. We are now 3 after one of my brothers passed away last year. I started living with my grandmother. We left with her just looking for casual jobs and doing what I
wanted to feed my brothers. I usually wake up at 5:30 in the morning. I prepare for the breakfast, prepare my sister to go to school.
It was last year when I came to know about partners in Kura.
When I joined there, they supported me. At least they gave me food security, which supported my brother and sister while they were in school.
We were given 3,400 to start. I started with 9 chicken.
Now, you guys in the
land. And my business is doing so well.
Academically, they supported me. I joined a vocational training. Spiritually, at least we now are together.
Yeah.
near to God because they introduced me how to worship.
Now it is my own salon. I'm self-employed.
They gave me the startup kits to start the salon. I can now depend on myself. I can help others. And I'm the breadwinner of my family.
And then they decided that I should be in my own house. Okay, here's my house. I like staying here because my friends come here, we chat. This is the place I like to be at this time. I try to put here my goods so that at least I can find some comfort. Yeah, because I don't have a pillow.
So when I'm in the group, we are very united, we are very happy. We share everything.
I can see our family is doing quite well. And I'm also able to feed my brothers.
At least for now, I can feel that I have a family which is partners in hope. I would like to be a lawyer because something in me, deep inside, normally tell me that there's some rights that need to be observed. And I think that through me, there's something is going to be achieved and justice is going to be found.
Financially, to give to Panua, it isn't that much. $20 covers blankets and pillows for one person. $50, it gives them enough money for seeds and tools for gardening, like we had in one of the videos. $125 is enough to purchase health and hygiene materials, and $250 is enough to help send siblings to school. You can also become a youth partner, which is a $1,095 total contribution for over 3 years, and that will allow you to help send one person through schooling. You can also become a business partner, which is a one-time donation of $500, and it helps provide startup kits for businesses for people in the Panua project. Last year, we donated $1,000. If we would have had $95 more, then we would have been able to become a youth partner. There are 168 people right now in Panua, and this is the third year of the school that they've been doing it. So last year when we donated, it would have been the second year that they had been sending people through, the second class that they were sending through the school. Join us in our hymn for the fruits of creation. It is hymn 97 in the United Methodist Hymnal.
Thank you.
This reading comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 8. Now this I say, he who is sparkly, no, sparingly, will also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each one must do as he proposed in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver. God is also able to make grace around you, so that always having a having all sufficiently in everything, you may have an abundance for every good deed. Now join us for hymn 114, Many Gifts, One Spirit.
Next reading comes from Matthew 6, verses 3 through 4. But when you give to the poor, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving will be in secret, and your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you.
Our next reading is from Mark 12, verse 41 through 44. And he sat down opposite the treasury and began observing how the people were putting money in the treasury. And many rich people were putting in large sums. A poor widow came in and put in two small copper coins, which amount to a cent. Calling his disciples to him, he said to them, "Truly I say to you, this poor widow put in more than all the contributions to the treasury. for they all put in one of their surplus, but she, out of her poverty, put in all she owned, and she had to live on. Now it be in a time of giving our gifts from our God, the presents, gifts, and services. If you would like to make a contribution to Panua, you can make your check out to Panua, or in the little envelopes in the pews, you can make it out to Panua. And we thank you for giving graciously those families and all those other people in Africa. Thank you too. Without your contributions, they would be virtually, they wouldn't be able to live without your contributions. So thank you for giving graciously. And Marcus and Pauline are going to pass out these colored cards. If you choose not to give to Panua, we ask that you pray for these people. On these cards is real people, and it has their name and prayers that you can say for them. For example, one of them is Esther, and she prays that you give her strength and guidance from the Lord. So if you just want to pray for them daily, that'd also be super rad of you.
Thank you.
Before we do our closing hymns, Nancy has a couple things to say.
Okay, we have a new way now to announce our offering. It's rad. So from now on, rad offerings are all we're going to do. Today, after the service, I'm going to ask the leadership team to meet in the Brown Parlor just briefly. Everybody else, head upstairs for the potluck. And after the potluck, we are going to be meeting in the Van O for some conversation about some exciting things that are coming up. And we welcome Rusty Harper back to the congregation. Kind of wave your hand there, Rusty. And please do say hello to him after the service. Also, we do need to do something about the Family Promise beds, and so we're going to need some strong muscles right after the service as well. Anything else that I'm forgetting? Okay. All right. Back to you.
That's a lot of money, more than I'll ever accumulate in my life. Okay, I'm sad. Please join us with Of All the Spirit's Gifts to Me, 336 in the United Methodist Hymnal. It's red, by the way. Sorry. Okay. And our final closing song is There's a Spirit of Love in This Place, 3148 in the Worship and Song book. Thank you. So just a reminder, since we're not begging money for you to go anyplace expensive anymore, all of our next fundraisers, the mystery dinner and the Subway sandwiches, all proceeds will go towards PNUA. And why we only said three, there's like the third class is because it takes 3 years to graduate from their program. So just a reminder. So thank you, God, for all these gorgeous people in this gorgeous place and this gorgeous world that you have created. We thank you for all that you have done for us and the wonderful people that you have filled in our lives. And we ask that you let us leave this place with open hearts and a safe travel home so that we may return to you in this place next week for more joy and love.